Hey guys, Max here, and the next iPhone may be just a few weeks away. So here's what to expect from the iPhone 13, or 12S, or whatever it's called. First off on the naming, I'm pretty 50-50 on iPhone 13 versus iPhone 12S. The upgrades we're expecting to see this year are pretty incremental, so it may be an SE-er, meaning some smaller, just refinements on the previous generation. But we might have some surprises and we might see some really big features that may warrant the name iPhone 13. Also, a lot of people think that 13 is an unlucky number, so there are a lot of factors at play here. I'm honestly pretty split on it, but whatever Apple calls it, I'm really excited for it. Even though there have been widespread reports that the iPhone 12 mini is failing in sales, Apple will be doing another four phone lineup with the iPhone 13 mini at 5.4 inches, iPhone 13 and iPhone 13 Pro at 6.1 inches, and iPhone 13 Pro Max at 6.7 inches. The 13 mini will most likely just be a smaller version of the 13. That was how it was with the iPhone 12 series, and it will make sense for Apple to continue that trend. The Pro lineup was a bit different last year because the 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max had not only a size difference, but also a camera difference because the 12 Pro Max got beefy camera sensors and a larger camera bump, and it looks like this year the 13 Pro will also be getting that treatment. In iPhone 13 dummy units and in case leaks, iPhone 13 Pro has a huge camera module, so that makes me think that the iPhone 12 Pro Max's huge camera module, that kind of trend will be continuing onto the 13 Pro, which would be cool to see. A big part of this new iPhone lineup that we're expecting to see is Apple's smaller notch, and Apple's able to shrink the notch because of a redesigned camera system which takes up less space than the previous generation. Another feature we were hoping to see on the iPhone 13 line is in-display Touch ID. This has become something that's in many Android phones, and with the current state of the world, it would make sense for Apple to integrate this technology, though Mark Gurman from Bloomberg reports this feature will not be making its debut this year. The flagship color this year is apparently going to be orange, and the standard 13 model will have a bright, beautiful orange that I think just looks so good, and the 13 Pro will have a bronze finish. Some of the biggest upgrades this year may be coming in the camera department. Sensor shift stabilization technology introduced on the 12 Pro Max may be expanded to the whole lineup, which would improve stabilization across the lineup. The regular iPhone 13 also now has a diagonal camera setup, which would allow for larger sensors for that sensor shift stabilization. The Pro models may also see an f1.8 lens for ultra-wide photography at night, which would be awesome because ultra-wide photos right now at night aren't the greatest, I'll admit it. Max Weinbach also reports that these phones will introduce portrait mode video, something we saw come to the iPhone, iPad, and Mac at WWDC in FaceTime only, but this may expand it to the camera app to make your videos look even better. Finally, this year, the 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max will likely have higher refresh rate displays at 120 Hz. That's on par with most Android flagship phones, and it's great to see Apple finally taking this step because it'll make the iPhone experience even better. These displays will be LTPO technology, meaning the displays can go fluidly from 1 Hz to 120 Hz to save battery and turn off the high refresh rate when it isn't needed because it does eat up a lot of battery. Speaking of battery, there have been reports that this generation will introduce larger batteries. The 13 Pro Max will have a 4,352 mAh battery. The 13 and 13 Pro, identical size devices, will have a 3,095 mAh battery. And the 13 Mini will have a 2,406 mAh battery. There might also be 25-watt fast charging, which is only an upgrade at 5 watts, which is still pretty slow. These battery upgrades are great to see because with 5G and 120 Hz, the batteries will take a bit of a hit. There have been recent reports that Apple integrated reverse wireless charging into the past generation, and it's only actually been able to be used with the MagSafe battery pack that recently came out. So apparently on the iPhone 13 series, this may actually make its official debut, which would also be cool to see. A rumor that's been going around is that this generation will feature always-on displays enabled by the LTPO display technology, which would be cool. But honestly, I don't really care that much about this feature. This lineup will also feature the A15 Bionic chip, which is a small upgrade over the A14, and it'll also feature Wi-Fi 6E, which is great for even better speeds if you have a Wi-Fi 6E compatible router. Now, when can we expect this new generation of iPhones to be announced? Sometime in mid to early September, if the supply chain allows. Last year, they held their iPhone event in October because the supply chain was running a little bit behind schedule because of COVID-19, and there was also a staggered release where two phones came out immediately and then two phones came out a month later, but we'll likely see a whole lineup being available at the same time this year. These phones will probably be announced alongside AirPods 3 and the Apple Watch Series 7, so there's a lot to be excited about this fall. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.